Hello everyone. In the previous video, we discussed what you mean by the time complexity as well as the space complexity of an algorithm. And we have defined that the time complexity of an algorithm can be calculated as the number of times the basic operation gets executed. Now in today's video, we'll see the time complexity of some of the sample codes. And we'll have an assumption that the basic operation of an algorithm takes a constant time. I have mentioned here that let's assume that the basic operation takes 1 unit of time. Now assume that in my algorithm, there is only one step. The step is sum is equal to A plus B. So this is the only step in my algorithm, and note that it gets executed only once. So what is the time complexity of such a code? So it is a constant, and the basic operation gets executed only one time, and I have assumed that the basic operation is being executed, the basic operation takes 1 unit of time, so the total time taken to execute this particular algorithm is 1. So I will mention that the time complexity of this particular code is 1. Now coming to the second code, in my second code there is a for loop which is being executed from 1 to n. And I'm having a statement sum is equal to sum plus a of I. Note that this is my basic operation. Generally, the basic operation is the innermost statement in a looping constraint. So in this looping constraint, there is only one instruction, that is sum is equal to sum plus a of I. And this statement gets executed how many times? It gets executed n number of times. So the time complexity of this particular code is n. Now coming to this part of the code, now there are two loops. The first loop ranges from 1 to n, that means I will have a value from 1 up to n, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 up to n, and j value, j is being executed from 1 to n. So for I, when I is having a value of 1, j gets executed n number of times. So j gets executed n number of times. Similarly, when I gets incremented to 2, so j gets executed n number of times. Similarly, when I is equal to 3, j gets executed n number of times. Irrespective of the value of I, j gets executed n times. So when I is having a value of 1, it gets executed 1 time. When I is having a value of 2, it gets executed n number of times. So here the total time complexity is each of the loop. So this is the outer for loop will be executed n number of times, and for each value of I, the inner loop j will be executed n times. So the time complexity of this particular code is n square, n into n. Hope this is clear. This is about the time complexity of the second code. Sorry, the third code. Coming to the next example. In the next example, I have two consecutive codes. In the first part of the code, there is a for loop running from 1 to n, and there is a statement sum is equal to sum plus a of I. Now, note that this particular code, that is this particular operation or the instruction sum is equal to sum plus a of I, will be executed n number of times because the loop is being iterated from 1 to n. Now in the next part of the statement, there are two for loops wherein each loop is being iterated n number of times. So in this case, there is a statement, if statement, if a of I greater than b of j, then swap a of I comma b of j. Okay, I think this is the most common code that we use in case of bubble sort. Note that in this case, the basic operation is not swap, because swap does not happen all the each time. Swap happens only if this condition is true. So note that in this second part, the basic operation is a of I greater than a of j, that is the comparison operation. The comparison operation will happen each time, but if this condition is true, then only this part will be executed. So among these two, I should consider the basic operation as the comparison statement, not the swap statement. Now, how many times this comparison statement gets executed? It depends upon how many times the inner loop gets executed and how many times the outer loop gets executed. So if you see, the inner loop gets executed n times and the outer loop gets executed n number of times. So it is n into n, n square. Now, if there is the consecutive statements in my algorithm, wherein first part takes n time and the second part takes n square times, now the biggest among these two is n square. So the time complexity of such a code is n square. Hope this is clear. Now coming to the next example. In the next example, there are three loops. Please, okay, if there are three loops, don't say that it is n cubed. So please check how many times each of this loop gets executed. Now in the first loop, that is for I is equal to, I has been executed 1 to n times. Let me write, I gets executed from 1 to n times. Now coming to the j loop. J loop gets executed depending upon the value of I. J is equal to 1, j less than or equal to I. When I is having a value of 1, j gets executed 1 times. When I is having a value of 2, j gets executed 2 times. When I is having a value of 3, j gets executed 3 times. And so on. When I is having a value of n, j gets executed n times. Now coming to the innermost loop, that is k loop. Now I've taken this as my basic operation. I have not denoted any statement. Assume that this is some basic operation. I need to check how many times this operation gets executed. Now k is equal to 1 to n times, 1 to 25 times. So if j is equal to, it depends. For I is equal to 1, j will be having a value of 1. And k will be executed irrespective, it executes 25 times. So k is equal to 25 times. Now, when I is having a value of 2, j gets executed 2 times. So 2 times of this thing, so is 25 into 2. So this is 25 into 2. So this is 25 into 3 and so on until 25 into n times. 25 into n times. Now, coming to the total time complexity, it is nothing but how to find 25 times first time, second time it is 25 into 2 plus 25 into 3 up to 25 into n. Now if I take 25 constant outside, it is nothing but 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to n times. So this is 25 into summation of 1 to n, that is nothing but n into n plus 1 divided by 2. Now assuming that 25 and 2 are constant, it is nothing but n square plus 1. N square plus n. This is nothing but n square plus n. Now this is, go back to the above one. Okay. So this is n square plus 1 n. Now out of these two, which is having a higher value? N square. So the time complexity of this part of the code, of the, this code is n square. Hope this is clear. Yeah. Coming to the next set of codes. Now here, I have taken a while loop wherein while n is greater than 0, I am performing some operation. Let me call this operation as the basic operation. I have not written what exactly is the basic operation. My objective is how many times this basic operation gets executed. And then after this, I have reduced the value of n by 2. N is equal to n by 2. So note that in each iteration, the value of n gets reduced by 2. Something similar to your binary search problem, wherein if my objective is to find a key element in a set of element, after I divide the array into two equal parts. Now I compare the key element with the mid element. If it is if it does not match, I will either search in the first part or I will search in the second part. So that is, I am searching in only one part. That means the problem size will be reduced to 2. Now in that particular case, if I reduce the problem into two parts, so here the time complexity, I can say it is log n to base 2. So please note that while solving some problems based on divide and conquer and decrease and conquer, we may come across the time complexity as n log n or log n in so many cases. So this is the time complexity of this particular code. Now coming to if n, while n greater than 0, there is some basic operation and I am reducing the value of n by 1. So how many times this statement gets executed? So until n greater than 0, if I assume that n value is 10, n value is 10, so it gets repeated, it gets iterated 10 times. So if the value of maybe, in general I can say, it is the basic operation gets executed n number of times. So in this case, the time complexity is n, because I have reduced the value of n by 1 after each iteration. Coming to the next set of code. Now if you see, there are three for loops and this is my basic operation. The first for loop, that is the outer for loop, has been executed 1 to n times. So I will write that it may have value from 1 up to n times. The innermost, that means the middle loop for j is equal to 1, it may extend up to I square times. So 1 square is 1. If I value is 2, it will be executed 2. 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16, and so on. this will be executed n square times. Now coming to the innermost for loop, that is k. K will be executed irrespective of whatever the value of j it is. For I is equal to 1, j will be executed for I is equal to 1. Maybe in this case it will be executed only one time. That means k will be executed n by 2 times. But whereas in the second iteration it will be executed 4 into n by 2 times. Next, it is 9 into n by 2 times. So it is 16 into n by 2 times. Similarly, it is here n square into n by 2 times. Now, how to find the efficiency of the time complexity? It is n by 2 plus 4 into n by 2 plus 9 into n by 2 plus 16 into n by 2 up to n square into n by 2. Now, if I take n by 2 a common, so it is 1 square plus, this is 1, this becomes 4. 4 is nothing but 2 square, 9 is nothing but 3 square plus 4 square up to last number is n square. Now, what is this value? I will take n by 2 outside right here. N by 2 into this summation of 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus 4 square up to n square is nothing but n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 whole divided by 6. So, in this case, it is I'll not multiply all those terms. So this is nothing but n into n is n square. N square into n is n cube. N cube into 2n. N cube into 2n is 2 into the power of 4. All the other things will be the lower order terms. So the time complexity will be n to the power of 4. This is how we find the time complexity of the sum of the sample codes. Let me take one more example. Let's consider this particular code, wherein you see the basic operation. This particular basic operation gets executed depending upon the outer for loop and the inner for loop. The outer for loop is being executed n number of times. So I have written here, I can have value from 1 to n, and j can have value for j is equal to 1 up to n, but j is not incremented by 1. It depends upon the value of I. When I is having a value of 1, so j will be incremented one time. So in the sense, when I is 1, j will be incremented n number of times. Now when I is equal to 2, j is equal to j plus 2. So j can start from 1, so the next value will be 3, and the next value will be 7, and the fourth value will be 9, 11, 13, and so on. So it implies that this j will be executed n by 2 times. When I is equal to 2, j will be executed n by 2 times. So when I is equal to 3, so it means n by 3 times. In the sense, this basic operation will be executed n by 3 times. When I is equal to 4, this basic operation will be executed n by 4 times, and so on. When I is having a value of n, this basic operation will be executed n by n times. So how to find the efficiency? Summate all this. This is nothing but n plus n by 2 plus n by 3 plus n by 4 up to n by n. So if I take n common, this is 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4 up to 1 by n. So this is n, and this whole value 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4 up to 1 by n, I can write it as log. This is about how we find the time complexity of some of the sample codes.